Yo, what's up, fam? It's your boy Vusi Max back in the building. This is an early video. It's around 8 o'clock now. You understand? It's around 8 o'clock. But me and Lucas, we're already up, aka Wafo. We're already up and we're trading. So I figured, you know what I'm saying? Today's vlog, I'm going to start it in the morning and then we're going to see what happens as the day goes. You understand what I'm saying? So if you're new to the channel, go ahead and subscribe, like, and click the bell notification icon. And let's just go ahead and go into the video. Same time. Hi, fam. So as you can see, hey, my Telegram is a little bit of a mess. And before that, I'm working on a video I'm gonna upload tonight. I don't know which one is gonna be out. I think I'm gonna drop this video and this one that you're seeing here, which is kind of like a podcast. It's gonna be coming later. I'm gonna drop both of them today. And like once, you know. So, what's the time? It's only 8 o'clock, half eight now. You know, you understand what I'm saying? So, already my Telegram is busy. And the reason is because we did this trade, Joe. Which was what time? This trade that we opened, wait, minus 100 now. This one that we entered at 3:30. South African time, in the midnight. It's only Monday session, you understand? So sometimes the market doesn't provide on Mondays, but sometimes, you know, it's like if you hit it big, you really hit it big. And sometimes if you miss, you know, you miss, and you have to be patient sometimes. But today's trade was fire, and I'm gonna show you now, because I'm only filming now using my phone, because the weekend was hectic and I don't know where I put my camera. But I'm gonna show you the charts that we open on Buffer's phone right now. Buffer, can you just open that in real quick so we can, yeah, can see what's up? Show us the NAS now. Oh wait, but this session is what, H1? H1?
Yeah, this is H1.
Yeah, but I think we can go to the alarms. It's almost London session. You wouldn't be surprised. Yeah, go to M15 or M5. So we can see exactly what's going on. Yeah, so that's where we entered. You understand what I'm saying? There was a little bit of a flag pattern. There's an invisible flag pattern. You can see it with.
Yeah.
So let me tell you. Let me announce something to you, fam. As you can see, the channel reached 15k subscribers, fam. You guys are sending so much love to the channel. 19k, from we hit 19k subscribers, is crazy. So we're launching a special now, only on the signals. The mentorship is still the same. I'm gonna put the link below. So for the signals now, fam, listen, only from now until 7 November, these are the signals for NAS 100 and USDT signals. They're all in the same package. So $35 for a month, $70 for 3 months, and $100 for 6 months. Listen, we're trying to help you out because you guys are showing the channel love. So, you know what I'm saying? If you want to grow your account, hit me up now. Put the link also there. Go to the public Telegram and then that's where you find all the links and stuff like that. So, it's still early in the morning. Like I said, I'm going to catch up with you guys, man, a little bit later. All right, peace out. All right, fam, so the first part of this video was yesterday, which was Monday, and today's Tuesday. So, I just want to catch up with you guys on what happened since then. For me, so on today's trades, you see this section here. We could have caught this trade somewhere there. We could have gotten a long trade there, but unfortunately we didn't because of the circumstances I was going through this morning. I wasn't able to, you know, so I wasn't able to catch this move here because of other situations, you feel me? But we saw what was happening here, which was the market formed this kind of support zone. And previously, this support zone was here, you see, but the price slightly moved higher, elevated to this level here. So we knew this was a level there, right? So when the price rejected here again, that's when we went long that's when the team went long. That's when I went long and I sent a signal to all the members and stuff like that. And we're waiting for a breakout here as another confirmation, because you see there's a trend line here. So if I can just zoom in. So this chart is even clearer than what it is now. You will see that this breakout here. So the market, what it does tend to do, you will tend to see a pin bar here. You can see this candlestick here. I don't know if this thing will allow me to focus. Let me just move this candlestick here. You see, it was a pin. So other people will take this as a signal that it's a rejection, so you need to sell and stuff like that. But that's why I'm telling you guys, you need proper strategies, because if you just take what you see on the internet, those things are there to sort of mislead you, because anyone who knows price action will say this is a rejection candlestick. But you see what happens after that, the price just kept rising higher and higher and higher and higher, and it reached our targets, and our SL was anywhere just below here, because there are chances that the market can still go and hunt your stop losses here, because they know there's liquidation here. So at this support level, there's a lot of liquidation, meaning there's a lot of money laying there in the form of stop losses and all that kind of stuff. So they know if they take the market here, they're gonna go and kick everyone out, and then the price can proceed in its original direction. So that's why we keep our stop losses slightly below our support zones. So the SL was slightly below, but the price didn't go to hunt any stop, which would have been they just came back and kind of did that false move downwards, and then the price went up in a very bullish manner, which was expected, and it was good. So I just wanna share with you guys what's going on here, because I think I told you guys already about the special that we're running, fam. I don't wanna disclose these taxes that you're seeing there, but I just wanna show you guys the results. Today's results only. You see, this is before 4 p.m. So immediately in NY session, which is 3:30 South African time, you can see all these results from different people. All these results from different people, fam. We're coming from only today's signal. So I'm glad the people ate today. And tomorrow, you know, it's going to be the same procedure, but hopefully I'm going to be there on the NY session. No, not on the NY. I'm always there on the NY session, but I'm talking about the London session. I'm going to make sure I'm there on London session so we can move it. And you understand, it's not too late for you to get started with us. Just join our public Telegram. It's in the pinned comment below, fam. That's the only thing you need in the building, you see. So the people ate today, right? So I guess we can go to the main topic of today's video right now. Let's go. So yo, fam, let's talk about today. I saw this comment on the YouTube on the other video. We're saying, what do you consider before placing an order? Meaning, what is it that I consider before I open any trade on any market and stuff like that? So I want to dive deeper into that one and talk about it briefly and concisely. Meaning, I won't say anything that I don't need to say and anything that doesn't need to be said. I only say what needs to be said. All right. So this is what goes down first, right? So you know that before you open any trade, before you consider any trade, before, the first thing you must do is analyze the market. So I analyze the market. And my analysis process isn't like the typical procedure anyone does to analyze the market. Meaning you just go to the markets and you draw trend lines and what, and then now you look for setups. Of course, I still do that. I go to the chart, I analyze, I look for setups, and I look at the structure. That's the first thing. So instead of just prioritizing on the trend lines and all those things and seeing what makes sense, the first things for me is the structure. Meaning how well is this chart oriented? In the sense that when I'm looking at these charts, before I even draw a trend line and whatever, can I see the general direction of where this market is going, right? So if a market, even if I can draw the most perfect trend lines, but if it's moving sideways, it's not the market that I'm gonna put my money on, because frankly I don't want to lose money. So the first thing is structure, which is the market direction and stuff. Yeah, I need the structure of the market to be obvious, meaning if it's pushing upwards, I don't want a market where I'm gonna think about it twice or stuff like that. I want a market where as soon as I look at it, I can see, okay, it's going upwards, it's going downwards, right? So after that, now the next thing that I'm gonna look for is that I'm gonna start doing my analysis after I found the structure, right? So meaning now that I know where this market is generally going, just like where the NAS 100 now, if you look at it on the daily time frame, and I don't have to open a chart because, you know what I'm saying, I know this chart, right? You can look at the NAS 100 now, it's pushing upwards. So after I know the direction of the chart, I'm gonna look at the trend lines now. I'm gonna start doing my analysis, right? I'm gonna start seeing the trend lines and whatever, and then I'm gonna start checking the time frames. So the first thing is the structure, the second thing I'm gonna do, draw my trend lines, and the third thing, I'm gonna start switching from the higher time frames, going lower and lower and lower. I'm doing this because I wanna find the best entries. Because if you're looking at a chart on a daily perspective, it's harder for you to like get a sniper entry because the daily candlestick can't really show you anything. The H4 is good for other things, but when it comes to trading indices, which is what I'm trading now, it's not really good. So you also need to know the instrument, the type of instrument you're trading. So you can't be trading NAS 100 on H4 and stuff because the volatility isn't gonna really show on the H4, right? So I'm gonna dial it down from H1, from day one to H4 to H1 to 30 to 15, right? And I'm doing this so I can compare what I'm seeing on all those time frames and decide which one is best for me to trade in, right? So the next thing, I'm gonna look for the market where the market is gonna retest, where the market can potentially break out. And although on those areas, this is the most important thing, on all those areas where the market can break out, I look for where the market can also fake out, right? So instead of seeing a breakout and thinking of buying or thinking of selling same time, I'm looking also for possibilities of fake outs. I'm not just gonna enter at the same time. I'm gonna wait to see if this market is gonna do a fake out or what. So this goes to my final point, candlestick confirmation, right? A rejection candlestick at a trend line isn't a candlestick confirmation. You need to wait for a rejection candlestick and then the next candlestick to form and complete. After that, I can see, okay, now this is going down because it just rejected and the next candlestick is bearish, so I can sell. But if I get a rejection candlestick and sell automatically, the next one, that can be a fake out, a trap for sellers, and then the next one can go up, right? Inversely, if I'm looking to buy and I get a rejection on a trend line at the bottom, I can't buy yet unless I see a bullish candlestick, engulfing candlestick, and all those things. So all those things are there for a reason. Don't miss out on any of these things. Prioritize on your candlestick formations and all that kind of stuff. It's your boy Vusi Max. Subscribe, like, comment, and Forex content is back in the building officially. Peace out, fam.